This is Pranav Guhat from EduTV. Today, we are with Mr. Kumar, the famous Mr. Anil Kumar, who is the principal of Delhi Public School, Faridabad. And he has taken the school to great heights, academics as well as sports, extracurricular activities, and he has been helping us a lot. Sir, we have Tashira from Alliance University, Bangalore. She will be the host. Tashira, over to you.
Good morning, sir. My name is Tashira Fernandez. I'm from Alliance University, Bangalore, and it's a pleasure to be interacting with you today. To start this conversation, sir, as you know, the pandemic has changed a lot for us. I think one of the most significant changes is that learning thus far has been in a very physical or personal mode, wherein there is always a physical interface. And I think the pandemic has completely changed this arrangement to a virtual imparting of knowledge. So I'd just like to know the sort of activities that your school has undertaken to kind of bridge this gap and transition into the virtual domain of learning.
Truly speaking, Tashira, at my place, we have been teaching children on a similar kind of a platform while in the classroom also. That was in 9th and 10th standard. So we were having tablets in the classroom already. And so this transition was not very difficult for us. Only thing was that we had to actually regulate on the basis of the net, which we were having the within the school compound earlier. Now it's like all over. So I'll say the activities which we are referring to is that complete school is running right now. If you were to talk about, like, I'll say the assemblies, the functions, very recently we conducted our investiture ceremony also virtually and the scholarship ceremony on the same platform. Rather, I'll say in the times to come, this will be more efficacious way of handling things comparatively in the near future also, once we are back to the normal frame of the school also. It will be a hybrid kind of a model, I personally perceive. So if you look at all the activities which were there in the calendar and were scheduled, they were all done as per schedule. We started from 6th of April and we have been continuing with the schedule the way it is supposed to be. I'll only suggest one thing is that, like, children, when they are talking about the activities, you have to have, I'll put a very different kind of a term. It is like collaborative competitions you have to more push in, basically. Like, wherein you create groups within of 5 students, 10 students, a small section of the kids who are participating, problem solving, understanding, enjoying life. And then at the same time, though it is definitely good to meet physically and then have your emotions expressed, but truly speaking, technology has bridged that gap beautifully. I only say is that how each one of us has adopted it is the one which makes a lot of difference. I'll say all activities for that matter. I'll say what we have done is that even the physical education periods on the clan and the school are going as usual. So what we are actually telling kids are like, okay, we will have pranayam today or we will have on the spot jumping. If there is nothing which you have to do, which we can't afford at a particular place and all that. If some houses are like some EWS kids are also there and where the spaces are very, very little and a little difficult for the teachers to actually handle those various other activities. In that case, I've told them, look, the best exercise is on the spot jumping. So you do the on the spot jumping and love the entire scenario. And the idea is that the blood circulation, which actually gets, stuck at a particular point in time when you are there on the screen for a long period of time, the best way is that you introduce these periods in the middle of it. So what we have done is that the timetable, which is running absolutely in the same frame as that of what we had. Only thing is that we have reduced the timings because it's a very focused learning now. What we are speaking, the children are listening as well as their ear pods are also on and then viewing the screen. So it's much more focused. And then there is no distraction from the other kids for that matter. So I'll say if it has its negatives, it has its positives also sideways. And soon we have to adopt to that as well. Yeah.
Good to hear that there hasn't been a lot of disruption in the learning, even during these challenging times. So my next question is, so as you know that these challenging times have brought on a lot of feelings of stress, anxiety, just loneliness, isolation, not just for, I'm sure, the faculty, but also for the students, because students want to be back at their respective schools. So what are the kind of engagement activities or the kind of activities that you have undertaken to, consistently maintain this enthusiasm or maintain the engagement, the morale of the students as well as the faculties.
Whether it is teachers, that is faculty you are referring to, or the other staff or the support staff for that matter, I'll take this as a complete unit.
Yes.
To bring their morale in place and to keep that up, the best way is that we have to have a solid team. They should not be feeling that I am the principal and they are the workers. No. That kind of a attitude we need to develop amongst ourselves. If I were to estimate right now, the rough figure will be about 30 odd teachers of my school and their families have suffered COVID. And you won't believe, not even a single teacher has taken a leave during that time, except for a day or two when the storm was high. The reason is, whatever they need as a support from team, Delhi Public School, Faridabad, it's at their disposal. And they don't need to even ask me. The standing instructions here are, look, whatever you need, just don't hesitate. Just don't hide. Be truthful. We are going to be serving you soon on that. So with that faith and with that, I'll say trust in the faculty and amongst the staff, each one of us is very open. They know if someone is having some kind of a symptom and all that, okay, they will be quarantined for the next 3 days. If they're coming to the school, they won't be reporting to the school. Then the leaves, etc., are automatically taken care of. For that matter, the COVID times have been such unprecedented. So you have to have unprecedented rules for that. So what we have done basically is that if someone has some kind of a symptom of any illness, what we have ensured is, okay, just take a break. Imagine, though I have said take a break, but they have not taken a break. None of the teacher, by their own free will, I have given them leave for 21 days, up to 21 days for each particular individual who is suffering or their family is suffering. But you won't believe their classes were all going on during this time. Despite my saying, don't take it, they took it. So the idea is, because the change which an individual needs for being happy, for being together, it is always comes with a particular teamwork, which is definitely, if I were to say, if I were to order this and all that, I'm sure they will run off from the scene. And you won't believe, as critical as to the extent of people going up to the ventilator level and to the ICU level in the school, but they are absolutely managing it well. I'll say God is kind to us. He has given us that wisdom and we are able to prevail upon on that. And it has come out well.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your insights and thank you for being here with us today. Have a great day.